Hey, this is Agent 355, and I have most of a Skaven team with me.
And you also have me.
Yes. We're up against Welfs, which is good, because they are not very killy, so our team should be fine. So we should actually be able to, like, live. These are War Dancers. They are the most bullshit unit in the entire game. They have a giant obnoxious half-row, and their touchdown animation is the worst in the entire game. It's awful.
And obviously they're the players you want to get all the touchdowns with.
Yes,
so.
Which is not what happened on Veloxel's team. On Veloxel's team, one of his War Dancers died and the other one never leveled. So he has a level 1 and a level 2 War Dancer on his 1500 DV team. This is, they are, however, stat monsters. His catchers are really, really good. Welfs, or Wood Elves, oh, by the way, are the elfiest of the elves. They excel at making plays with leaping and passing, and they're really, really fast, and they're really, really fragile. They're probably, like, you know, aside from, like, Pelfs, pro-elves, they're probably, like, the most classic of the elves.
Yeah.
Their catchers are really fast, the war dancers are really fast, and that's kind of the team's whole thing. They also get trees for big guys, but trees are fucking awful, so you'll never see trees.
Also, they're the biggest egotist because their picture, their little flag thing, is just a war dancer.
Yeah, they're
assholes.
We get inducements, which is cool. I really wanted another 10 so I could get a bribe and stomp all of his dudes, but I don't have enough. I can only get a babe.
Only a babe.
Both of us have a loner. Veloxel actually said, well, can I have a recovery game? And I was like, fuck you, I have a loner. You can keep have a recovery game. What kind of ass are you?
Fuck you, I've had players out every game ever. Always.
Yeah.
And then they died.
We do have, do we have four gunners or three gunners? I think
we have four gunners right now.
Four. I don't think I'm missing any.
None have died
yet.
Oh,
yeah, look, there they all are in their capes. Oh, yeah. Now, blitzes are good. Where's that ball going?
Way over there.
Yeah, I think it's way in the back, which means I am not...
You only have one Storm Vermin.
Yeah, Lenny is missed next game.
Like always.
Yeah. What do you mean, like always? He's only missed, like, one game. But no, he's...
Yep.
Which is this one. So
one of them is always
fine.
Missing.
I don't have piling on, but I don't need the claw, because all of his dudes have armor value 7.
So you just need the tackle.
Yeah, so and I have tackle. So Lenny's got just as George, and George has Mighty Blow tackle, so he should be pretty good at killing elves.
Yeah, totally.
I should go well. So
yeah.
Because these are elves, and I actually having a roguer makes me stronger than him, I actually put the roguer on the line because I know he can't punch it. So it means less of my line rats getting punched. Here I go and I mark all of his dudes because, again, he's elves. If I'm making him play a punching game, I'm probably going to come out ahead because I have Storm Vermin with Mighty Blow and the Roger.
And you've got the guy with the horns.
I got the guy with the horns. So I'll probably come out ahead if he does that.
Yeah.
The other fun thing I can do this game that I haven't been able to do in a long time is number 11 and number 14, our two new gunners, are both shit. And because they're shit, I can actually use them to, like, screen areas and let them be blitzed. Because they have no skills. What do I care if they get blitzed?
I really wish that Cyanide would let you set automatic or manual camera in the options so you don't have to do it every game.
Yeah, I know. The camera is awful. Recording because I have to control the camera, so I'm trying to, like, be a cameraman at the same time.
Right.
Which,
you know, they pay people for that in real LPs.
Yeah. Yeah, they probably do. I know they pay people for that in, like game videos. People actually go into the game. It's effort. Who wants to do that?
Not me.
Not me. So, the whole thing with with Wood Elves is they have a War Dancers, which start with Blodge and Leap. And they're really fast. They're almost as fast as Gunners, and they start with Blodge and Leap. That was a line elf who needed one SPP to get a level, so.
Yeah.
So the Wood Elves are, like, really good, and they typically will get things like Strip Ball, so you can't cage against them, and everything's just terrible. What you typically do with a Wood Elf team is you run down some catchers, very similar to how I do it with my Skaven with my Gunners, is you run down some catchers and Wood Elves, and you put enough players downfield that he can't really do anything, and then you hand off and pass. It's very similar to the Skaven game. The difference is they're a bit slower. They don't have any blitzers, per se. And all of their players are squishy, as opposed to Skaven, where most of my players are squishy.
I would feel the War Dancer could be a blitzer. I mean, well, most blitzers just start with block, and yeah, the Dancers start with block.
But the War Dancer is also very, very valuable, and also a high... Yeah.
Yeah, Roger.
But the War Dancers are very, very valuable, and you don't often want to just do nothing but blitz with them. A lot of times they're doing other things like Strip Ball and stuff like that, or being in horrible places. So where I have blitzers, my Storm Vermin, who I can literally just run up and put on people, even if I'm not blitzing with them, and that way next turn I can punch with them. So my thought was, if I surround all of his dudes with my dudes, that's good, right?
No.
No, it is.
Then you just get out.
You can't get out, though. The War Dancer can get out. The other guys are next to Prehensile Tail and have to dodge into a tackle zone. That's Khemri odds right there.
But Khemri odds are the best odds.
So, and also I couldn't really use my guy, so I'm just trying to restrict his movement over there. And then I want to blitz somebody with Lenny, because Lenny only needs 2 Kaz and he'll level. And these are elves, so I should be able to get 2 Kaz.
Right. Right.
That's the goal.
Yeah.
I run the Strip Baller down here. Because if Strip Baller's down there and he doesn't move the ball this turn, then I'm totally just going to take it with the Strip Baller.
Yeah.
That's the idea.
Yeah, totally works.
So, and then I want a bunch of Lenny.
Yeah. And so just, whatever. It's a shitty gunner. He can provide an assist.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, George.
That's fine. That's fine. That's no big deal. And that's it. Now, some people might look at the time of the video and go, "What, Agent, why is the video so fucking long?" In which case, I'll tell you, Voloxel did it. Yeah.
Yeah, I too asked, why is this video so fucking long?
Yes,
and I looked at it.
And it's extra fun for me, because Flare Knight wants to go to bed, and now he has to commentate like a 40-minute video.
Yeah, and then there's another half.
And then there's another half, which is of undetermined length for the viewers at home, but I know how long it is.
Yeah, it's shorter than this one.
Don't tell them that.
Smaller. It was smaller in the file size. This was 600 megabytes of video stuff.
Spoiler alert, Flare Knight.
I don't remember how big the second half is, but how do you... Come on.
Oh, you shouldn't expect them to know that it's smaller than the longest video in the entire series.
I mean, like how do you have 600 megabytes of Blood Bowl stuff? I
edited out 11 minutes of video as well.
Like, this isn't even the fire pitch where the editing looks goofy. This is... Snow pitch.
No. It was, I edited out 11 minutes. The video was 11 minutes longer before I hacked it to pieces.
Oh, okay.
Which is...
Why do you only play people that take 5-minute turns?
I don't know. I mean, I never take very long. I shouldn't say never. Never's a bad word, but I don't take very long very often. So, right now he's knocking down a bunch of rats. I have yet to knock down an elf. Well, I guess the loner failed to dodge. I guess that counts. But I've only had 2 blitzes so far, and here comes the pass.
Wait for the interception.
No, everyone's on the ground.
Aw.
And my pass.
Perfect spiral.
And my pass block was just a single square too far away.
Aw.
Number 9. He was 4 squares instead of 3 squares.
The perfect spiral, though.
It's fine though. My Strip Baller is out of position. However. Because his catcher has 2 strength, and Speedy has wrestle, it's almost just as good as Strip Ball.
Yeah.
I can just go run over there and wrestle him down, hopefully.
Yeah. Yeah, provided nobody else gets near Speedy.
Yeah. No, Speedy's got to leave. No matter what you do, Speedy's going to go exactly where he wants.
There needs to be more blood on this pitch. Taint the snow red with suffering and sorrow.
What are you, like a $3 fantasy novel at the used bookstore?
Yes, I'm like a $3 fantasy novel at the used bookstore. The saddest of all books.
Good job, Roger.
Good job, buddy.
No, it's fine. I mean, like, you can't expect the Roger to do everything all the time. He just moved, like, two turns in a row. What do you want from him?
Yeah. He moved two turns in a row, and he knocked down a dude.
No, he didn't. Oh, well, I guess his tail did. But no, he rolled a one anyway, so... So, let's put the stinky guy over here. Alright, no, I guess that's the ugly one. The stinky one's gonna go next to the war dancer. I find it really important when you are the coach of a team to try to cultivate a positive environment, which involves referring to all of your players as the stinky one or the ugly one.
No, number 3 is the stinky one, and number 13 is the ugly one.
No. It's the other way around, because you can be... He's so ugly, you can't punch him, but the other guy's so stinky, it makes you can't catch the ball.
No, 13 has foul appearance.
Yeah, foul appearance, as in... No, foul appearance is the other one. Disturbing presence is the one with the aura.
Yeah.
Foul appearance is ugly, which is the punchy one. And disturbing presence is stinky, which is the passing one. I was right.
But you said...
No, I was right. I was right, Flair Knight. I didn't knock yourself down.
You said it backwards.
I was correct, Flair Knight. You are, in fact, wrong. You are wrong.
You said it backwards.
It's fine. I got the ball now. And
what are you going to do with the ball?
And I could have, like...
Picked it up.
Or I could have picked it up with Speedy, but he already blitzed, and I would rather pick it up with this guy, and then just throw it over here.
Yeah, whatever. You can do it. You can catch the ball.
Nope.
You probably should have waited to move that rat first.
Nope. You thought I was going to throw it, didn't you?
Yes.
If it was Speedy, if I could have thrown that with Speedy with free extra agility, I totally would have.
I would have moved the rat and then thrown the ball.
I can't.
You should have moved number 8 first and then moved Deadmau5.
Where would I move number 8?
I don't know where he was just then before he got people on him.
No. Because the whole point of throwing it to him would be that so he could dodge out and go score. It doesn't make any sense if I just stood him out where he wasn't in tackle zones and then threw the ball. That doesn't actually make any sense.
Oh.
That was the reason I was thinking about throwing it, was so that he could score, not so that he had the ball.
Oh,
It's definitely safer where it is than it would be up by number 8. So now I'm going to get punched again.
Right.
My rats have...
No deaths.
No deaths. No my rats have been very good at not being dead.
Yes. It is, in fact, their best skill right now.
They kind of failed at it last game, but I think they're coming back.
Yeah. Well, it's a learning process.
Making rad comebacks. Rad comebacks at not being dead.
Also, wasn't it 2 games ago?
No, Nurgle was last game. That's why I'm placing... Okay. That's why I have a loner in 1380 TV.
Yeah, for some reason I thought it was...
Johnny died 2 games ago. If that's what you're...
I'm still sad about
Did you ever see Sandlot? That the kid's baseball movie?
No, I didn't.
Well, there was one kid in there who was really fat, and they called him Ham. And I'm not going to call you Ham because you're fat. I'm going to call you Ham because your acting sucks.
That was a really laborious joke.
Yeah, I kind of went all the way around to get back to that one.
I mean, you could have gone with, like, you know what they call William Shatner or something like that? You know? Star Trek reference? Anything?
I don't know what they call William Shatner.
He's a ham.
Oh.
That's what his acting is.
I don't get it.
He's a hammy actor.
I don't get it. Could you explain the joke for me? That will make it funny.
There was no joke.
Oh.
I was explaining where you should have gone with your joke.
Oh. I took a wrong turn at the punchline. It ended up in the soup bowl. Get it like a punch, like at that, like, yeah. Get it?
No.
Like punch, like, you know, like I got punched or I
no.
took some punch.
No, it's multiple jokes.
I feel your commentary is slipping because you're tired and also bad at commentary.
That's not true. Okay, maybe that second part's true.
Well, so far nothing much has happened. I promise in this 40-minute game that or 40-minute half that things actually do happen. It's just not yet.
Well, my commentary will make more sense when things start to happen.
I kind of want to strip that ball, because when do you not want to strip balls? Bitch be stripping balls. Get it? Okay. Get it, like, tripping? Dan Pirano, he's gonna go get in on this action. I'm trying to think what I want to do. I'm trying to say, okay, where do I want to go? What I realize is in order to not make a bunch of going for it and be a horrible person and have a bad time, is I need to punch down number 10.
If you don't punch down number 10, you're going to have a bad time.
Yeah. Stop saying memes. Oh.
That's not true. They're not entirely memes.
Oh, man, you are. Your quality is just plummeting.
Well, if I go far enough down, I'll come out the other side and emerge transcendent, like a rising phoenix.
Let's see. Will this work?
Yes.
I'm trying to think if this will work for the dodging that I'm going to need to do.
Well, he's going to be on the ground.
Yeah, I know, but I might need to move through the space that I'm in, you see?
Oh.
I'm like, okay, no, this is fine. See, so, like, if I had pushed him forward, you see, I could have made a space for myself to dodge. But because I didn't, it's not going to work, but I decided it's still a better idea to just make the going for it than dodge through the tackle zones.
Right.
And I was just about to do this. I'm like, wait, no, that's not right. That's dodging into tackle zones. I'm trying to... I really, really, really want to use what's-his-face for this. Because...
Strip ball wrestler?
Yeah, a nice rat. I really want to use a nice rat for this, because then Speedy would be in a position to go pick up the ball and run away.
Right.
You see? But if I can't get in a position to pick up the ball and run away...
There you go. That's it right there. You got it.
Yeah, I mean, it's good enough. I don't like making two going for it, but it's better than any other option I got.
He did it. He's fine. Okay, never mind me.
Well, he made the going for it.
Yeah. That's the important part.
So, when I played the Nurgle, to remind everyone, because it was such a long week, when I played the Nurgle, I rolled a lot of dice, and a lot of them were ones.
Yes.
I'm not saying it's going in that direction, but, well, I think this game hit some key notes that last game hit as well. Namely, 2+ rolls are hard. No, and then he passes it. He passed it.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Good.
Yes. Yes.
And end event. Bam.
It did something!
And I saw that, and I was like, that was good. I like this guy. Speedy, you're the best.
Speedy.
So, I guess that kind of makes up for the fact that I basically snaked a roll.
Yeah.
That helps.
Yeah, that was good. Good, 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 good play all around.
Everything.
That's going to end up on BB ESPN's top 10 plays of the week. You know?
I could see that, yeah.
Yeah. Huh.
And
followed by Action News Team 9 reporting.
And here's a plus agility catcher that I want to die.
Is he going to die?
Yeah, well, we got to kill the stat whores.
Yeah.
Yep.
Kill
and then
kill everything. Yeah. Dead.
And he didn't apple it, so yeah, he's just nicked. Let's get dead.
Get dead.
Okay, that's good. One stat whore off the pitch.
Murder everything.
There's another stat whore that's a plus strength catcher, but that was his plus agility one, and now he's only got two catchers and two war dancers, so feeling good.
Murder everything for the blood god. The blood for the blood god of war. Murder. Kill.
Shut up, Fortnite. So, what I want to do is I want to run Speedy down the pitch, but I really would rather score with either, oh, by the way, our new gunner is named Lester the Lab Rat.
Okay, because I saw that thing. I can explain his story.
Oh, have you been thinking about this before? Did you write it somewhere?
No, I don't do that. I have to say,
given how this has been going so far, if you were to make something up off the top of your head, I would question how it would work.
Well, okay. The reason he's named Lester the Lab Rat is got nothing to do with, like, anything.
It's not a reference to a TV show.
No.
Which is exactly what it is.
No. See, what it is, okay, is that he is actually his name is actually Lester Like a Boss Rat. And LAB is the shortened version of it.
I was wondering where you were going with that, and I'm like, okay. And then you're like, see, and then it's like a boss, and I'm like, oh. Okay, well, that doesn't entirely suck. You can stay in the call for a little while longer.
Well, you see, he's actually the successful manager. Oh,
I have terrible news.
What?
The loner took the number 10 when he joined the team, so he took Johnny's number.
Well, that's fine. He's a loner. He can get kicked off the team later.
Yeah, he'll be kicked off later. But right now, he's using the sacredest of numbers.
The sacredest of numbers.
This is the worst. See, so he went from like, if he had just walked forward and instead of making a vanity pass, he made a handoff, he would have scored, and he would be up 1-0. Instead, I have a rat in scoring distance and a bunch of rats protecting him, and it doesn't look very good for.
And you killed a dude.
Yeah, and I killed a dude. So things are looking up.
Yeah, well, you see, Lester the Lab Rat is actually the successful owner of a series of Harry's Humaneos, which is the Chuck E. Cheese's of rat culture, you see? And
Could you spell Humaneos for me?
Humanio apostrophe S.
Okay.
Yes. So, and his managerial skills were so good that even though he was the boss, he was like a boss, the boss. So, after Johnny's death, the team coach, which isn't you, but some other guy, we're working on that, he decided we needed real leadership in the team. We needed somebody who'd been in the trenches. And as everyone knows, there's nothing more trench warfare than having to manage a pizzeria with a built-in arcade for, like, 7-year-olds and stupid animatronic, like, dancey puppet things. So he hired Lester Like a Boss Rat to deal with this. So they're trying to make him the new leader, the like a boss of the team.
Hmm.
Yes.
You have weird stories. What goes? Well, what do you do with your free time?
the exact
Uh-oh.
Same thing. I
Uh-oh.
Do.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Oh, he's fine. Yep.
He's fine. He's good.
He's still fine. He's, all right. He's fine.
Yeah.
Who needs fucking block?
Yeah.
I do. Need block. Please vote block.
Not Lester.
Please vote block. Or wrestle.
Well, see, what goes on in my head is the exact same stuff that goes on when I'm on a microphone. It's just there's nobody around to listen to it.
Oh, I see.
Yep.
And now... Ha! He uses his reroll. Free murder block. All right. Didn't do anything. Would have been funny if he died. And now he's right next to the war dancer. Look. I didn't have to blitz him. I could just punch it.
Let the liquids flow from his broken and shattered spine.
Hey, tackle. Tackle to the thing.
Tackle.
Yep. No.
Piling on.
Nope. Yep. It's not Lenny.
Foul it.
Mad rat. I would foul it, but I don't have anyone in position. I'm big on fouling. I am, but I'm also big on doing at the appropriate times.
Foul with the Roger.
I want to clear up a spot so that Lester, the Lab Rat, can just dodge through and score.
Like a boss rat.
The Lab Rat can just dodge through.
Like a rat.
I loved Bill Nye as a kid. You'll never get me to call him anything except Lester the Lab Rat. That's the whole reason why he got my seal of approval was because it was from the Bill Nye.
His name is like a boss rat.
I like the joke. It was a really, really good joke. I'm not calling him that. And look at the Roger actually doing things.
Yeah, Roger's like on his best behavior performance.
We just totally ignored him, and he was just like, guys, I'm doing stuff.
Well, you know, he's standing right next to Lester. You know,
it's true.
Lester's preparing his performance evaluations, and if the Roger doesn't provide very well, he's going to get a very stern letter.
You ever thought about a job stretching taffy? Because you're good at stretching things.
I don't think I'm employable.
Go, Lester. New gunners only need 2 touchdowns to level, and they're frankly almost as good at scoring touchdowns as regular gunners. So it's really nice. Remember, yeah. The whole point of gunners is you pick defensive skills because their offense is already impeccable. So. Yeah. Leveling up gunners, the good news is whenever a gunner dies, it's typically very easy to replace them, because you can just level up a new one to at least level 2 or 3 pretty quick.
Yeah. And then they die again.
Okay, so now so last time I got a blitz, and this time, I got a blitz!
Yay!
Now last time, to be fair, my blitz did approximately jack diddly crap.
Right.
So we'll see how this one works.
And he even built a strong line so you can't do anything with your blitz.
Are you kidding me? I have a guy with a leap.
Oh, yeah, that's right, you do.
Leap is, the best thing. Now, I really want to punch the plus strength catcher over there, who's number 4, but my murderer would have to make going for it, and I decided I didn't want to punch him that badly, so I'm going to punch number 5.
Yeah.
Because the catchers only have 2 strength, so it's really easy to just blitz them.
Blitz and murder.
Yeah. Killing war dancers is great, but Velox's war dancers aren't very good. So, also, I don't have any guards, so I couldn't get to 2DP.
They're no Henrietta, that's for sure.
Henrietta's a Chaos Warrior, and most people aren't going to get that joke. Henrietta's a Chaos Warrior on a friend of ours' team who has, 5 agility and, strong arm and accurate and, just long bomb. The entire game, just long bombs from downfield.
Yes, and it's died twice, and once it got lost to...
Nope.
Okay.
All right. That's what I said. That's, rolling 2 pluses is hard.
Yeah, well, you need to roll 3 pluses, or 4 pluses, or 5 pluses.
Yeah, I know, that's the way you win games, is you just say, well, if I can't roll 2, then clearly I better roll 5.
Yeah, it's what I do.
It is. Well, I've already rolled a 6, I already just intercepted the ball.
Yeah.
In 2 tackle zones, so that was totally a 6 plus, I think.
Yeah.
It's a 4 plus regularly, with no tackle zones, so 2 tackle zones would be a 6 plus, yeah. So, that was already bullshit lucky. It's funny, in this first half, I remember when I played it, and I remember, and even watching it now, I was really frustrated at my inability to do pretty much anything. With the, I kept snaking things, I snaked blitzes, I failed to knock down players, my murderer was not actually murdering anybody. And it was going really poorly, and then he was about to score, and I was not irritated, but just oh well, nothing's working. And then,
yeah, but you're doing okay.
Yeah, and then pass block worked. I'm like, okay, well, I've had exactly one turn where things have worked, and that means I'm up 1-0 because I'm rats.
Yeah. Exactly. I had to play rats. Goomball, and it sucked. It was terrible.
Yeah, no, rats are really good, especially against teams that against bad players. You wouldn't have to know any of those, would you?
No. I only play super professional Khemri teams.
I was just checking. I love Khemri. Khemri and Goblins are my favorite teams that aren't any good.
Yeah.
Most of the time, I'd rather just play teams that actually stand a chance of winning. But I love Goblin and Khemri. They're so fun.
Khemri have one play. Give the ball to the Doom Guardians. It's kind of a good play. When it works.
Khemri have the play of, I have 5 strength guys who have no nega trait, and I'm just going to punch everybody all the time. So, it was kind of unfortunate that the blitz didn't go well, because now all of my rats are on the ground. And my pass blocker is stunned.
so you can't do any more bullshit.
Yeah, so I can't like actually block that pass. Look at him. Look at him even passing right over his corpse. Like, can't block this one, can you? It's like, no, I can't.
No, I cannot. Zip it in. And then he stands here for a while.
Yeah, well, there's a reason it's a 40-minute game. If you've been paying attention to the clock, you would realize every one of his turns goes down to 2 minutes or more.
I have not paid attention to anything.
That hurt.
Well,
the good news is I have a babe, but his player isn't coming back, so... And he doesn't have any spares. I mean, we both have loners, so every player you're down is a player.
Roger Blitz. Out. Roger Blitz. Roger Blitz. Blitz the War Dancer. Do it. You know you want to, past agent.
I don't want to. I have a strip baller.
If he had blitzed, he would have done it too, because he got the pass.
I have a strip baller. If she was two scores from the sideline, I would have surfed her. But she isn't. I can't surf her.
Wait, is she not?
No, she's three.
She's not.
I could push her to the sideline, but I could not surf her. On the other hand, I can easily just strip the ball out.
Provided you don't fail this dodge.
No, it's fine. I'm really good at rolling dice. I've definitely rolled my last snake eyes for this half. Definitely. Okay. Definitely the last one.
Definitely the last one ever.
So this is really good. So let's see. Both Deadbow 5 and Lester both have 3 SPP, so if either one of these guys score, they'll level up, which would be really good. So I'm going to run one down here, and I'm going to run the other one over here to pick up the ball.
Yeah, you can do it. And
then I'm going to punt it. And it's a nice, easy punt. It's only like a 3. It's only like a 4+.
Go, right. Go, Lester. You can do
and
it, Lester.
And I'll just punt it down the field.
Yeah.
And then I'll probably score next turn, which would be great. Yeah. Oh,
go,
wait.
Lester.
Oh wait, nope. 2+ rolls are really fucking hard, guys. And then and then the ball lands in 0 tackle zones, and I don't have any rats who are anywhere near to defend it. So
that's bad.
This could have gone better. I'm not gonna lie, I was mildly irritated at the number of dev skills I did.
Yeah, this is
which to be fair seems like a bad thing to be. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Aww.
We don't love you. Goodbye. It's not even like it's a thrower. They're completely disposed. They're basically line rats, guys. So he's dead.
I requested our next one be like, what's a cheese that starts with T? I have to look on Google for a second. You commentate.
Let me carry the commentary while you look on Google. So I realize it seems like really silly to be mad at dice. And to be fair, you can ask for Voxel. I wasn't even that mad, but I'm going to commentate it because I was going to talk about it because I was doing it. But it seems a little silly to be irritated about dice when you're winning 1-0. But I've rolled a lot of dub skulls, and I have not hurt very many elves, and I'm a little bit miffed. It was very disappointing to me.
We could name our next gunner Tim Telemia. That's not a made-up cheese name. It's an actual cheese.
Feta got this next game.
What?
Good
Yay,
job,
Feta,
king of this fucking team. The best line rat. He gets injured every fucking game, and he does not die. No, seriously. That guy gets hurt, like, every game.
Well, no, he gets hurt every second game, because...
Yeah, that's true. No, sometimes he badly hurts. He gets hurt, like, every game. It's really bad. And I think the elves score now, because this looks bad.
The power of friendship.
the power of vanity blocks. So I was all excited because I was like, great, I have a 2-man advantage on him. If my guy comes back, I'll have a 2-man advantage. That's really good. And then in one turn, he killed one of my players and missed next game and another. So now not so much.
Yeah, it's kind of a problem.
A problem is only a solution that you haven't found the answer to yet.
What?
No. Gandhi said it.
No, that's just wrong. I don't even...
Gandhi said
that's
it.
Wrong. Are you even sure that's a Gandhi quote?
No, I really, 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 really wanted him to not score or to stall because I could have, like, gotten a triple serve easy. I really wanted it to happen.
Are you sure that Gandhi said that?
Positive. Yeah. So my guy didn't come back, so I went from having a 2-man advantage to a 1-man disadvantage. The good news is that it's 2 line rats, basically, who are out. But Speedy's also out, which is sad. But he's KO'd, and I have a babe, so maybe he'll come back at the end of the half.
Yeah, and that's soon anyway.
And they're pouring. And
then it starts raining.
And they're pouring rain, which kind of hurts both of us equally, so no big deal.
Die. Die.
Please. Please die.
Die, so that we may know peace.
Nope.
Nope. Piling on. Oh, wait, no.
Nope. Nope. This is the bad rat. So I have I have this loner here, and I realize I'm probably not going to score. I mean, I'm going to try. I'm going to run 11 and 14 out. And you know, wish him the best of rat luck.
Yeah.
But I also really want to... Yeah, I'm going to kind of play this weird. But I also really want to, like, stomp on somebody with number 10, because he's a loner. That's what they're for. But in order for me to get the good stomp in, I want to get, like, a little bit of a gang foul going. I don't just want to stomp unassisted, because the even if it is a loner, the odds of getting a player ejected are too high.
Yeah.
So I just use the Roger and get a 3DB and knock him down, and I have a gang foul right here, but then he gets stunned, and
yeah.
And stomping on stun dudes is dumb, because if you break armor, they can't get double stunned. So, I really wanted to stomp on him, but now I can't. I really want to. That's my story. That's my story. I wanted to stomp on elves, and now there's not really a reason to.
I see.
And look at me completely not protecting the ball at all, because why bother?
So they don't score?
He's elves. He only has one turn. He can't score. I can score. So my thought is, if he wants to get to the ball... He's going to have to devote resources to it, and then maybe I can just strip it and take it back. And if he wants to get to the... Or he can try to stop the score by marking all the gunners, and that's fine too. That's just another thing he can do. But he can't do both, and he can't score, so I didn't really worry about not protecting the ball as much as I might.
Yep. This video still has like 3.5 minutes left. That's my contribution for this.
Blame the luck. So the good news is next video is shorter.
Yeah, it's only like half as long.
Only like. Well, it doesn't take very long to take your turn when you have no players.
Dun dun dun
dun dun dun dun dun, dun, dun foreshadowing. Dun, dun.
Foreshadowing. Dun, 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 dun. Foreshadow.
My gunner leveled up and I gave him foreshadowing. Who needs gunners anyway? Like, gunners are like the worst player on a Skaven team.
Yeah. I wish you could just have a team full of rogues.
Yeah. The roguer's the best.
Yeah.
Did you know
12 rogers?
Did you know rogers intercept the ball 100% of the time?
Yeah, it's a secret skill.
Secret skill. But just like Beast of Nurgle from last game.
Yeah.
That was a stupid friggin' interview. Yeah, at least he held in his tongue. That was funny.
Intercept ball with tongue. 100% chance of success.
he's marking all my rats. They're all.
What's the player that puts the ball on their spikes when they carry it? I forget which one it is.
I'm sure if I know that one.
I thought there was a player whose model of them holding the ball is like they impale it on one of their many, many spikes or something.
I know there's pictures like that, like with an orc or something like that, but I don't know if that's actually an in-game model thing.
Oh.
Boy, Veloxel, why does it take you so long to decide what to do? Like, you get one blitz. You can move a bunch of dudes and then blitz someone. That's all you can do.
Yeah.
So I forgot something at the end of this half.
What'd you forget?
I forgot when players get injured, it's important to remember what they've done and what's injured about them, so that you can still use them correctly. So if get out, loner.
So if you got the guy who's only got agility 1.
Yeah, no, he's gone. But we do have a guy with agility 2.
Okay. Oh, I see where this is going.
Yeah, I didn't pay attention to the dice log, so I'm curious to see if this makes a difference. But I really need my gunner to pass. So if I want to score, my gunner has to pass. So there ain't much point to blitzing with the gunner, say. Oh, that's right. That's what happened. I remember. I found more Chug skulls. The thing I'm talking about happens in the next half.
Oh, so you spoiled it.
More Dub Skulls. That's four. Four Dub Skulls.
You spoiled it for us.
Or Snake Eyes. Snake Eye Dub Skull. It was a good name. And my gunner didn't come back. Huzzah!